Anyways, hi, I'm Stephen Walken, Steety Films. It's currently the afternoon, kind of ish. Anyways, even though that's the Amazon man just been and gone, and today we'll be opening, and that is, once we take off this really nice packaging from good old Amazon, as it is, and we got ourselves not one. Oops, that's right, the camera just went up. Same low battery, and not one, not two, not three, but four items we're going to go through today. And despite my pre-order bonuses is another thing. And today going to be opening, and that is Monsoon's Arise, that comes with the steel book and also some keychains, key rings, keychains, potato potato. And yeah, I thought I'd pick this game up today because it only just came up today. And I do enjoy the Monsunter series. Let's move all of this up to the side for a moment. Because of I do enjoy the Monsunter series because I played through quite a few Monsunter games before in the past. Even though that's in Monsunter World, did so very well. And it's basically Monsunter World, this is. But in a small form factor, and it took a lot of sacrificing to be able to get this running on the good old Nintendo Switch. And it's nice that it's came out today. I'm looking forward to playing it because the demo kind of sold me again, knowing the demos and whatnot. And I didn't know if it was good enough. And it was really, really good enough, even though that, I don't know if it says, yeah, here it is. It runs on the, I wonder why it says that. In-game purchases. That's a bit odd. Anyways, what I'm trying to say is that he uses the RE engine, you know, and the RE engine is a really good engine for what Capcom has produced. It supports amiibos and all that. Anyways, we'll get into that in a minute. Anyways, but yeah, that the artwork is quite good. You got, like I say, monster and the attack, and they got some really cool new features using, like, these like wing hook things, you know, they're like grappling hooks and whatnot you can utilize in the game and all that. So here's the front, here's the side, here's the back, tells you more about the game. Then there's all the equivalent things you can do. Even though it says 1-1-1, I like that. 1-1-1-1. Only single player game. And it has like online compatibilities to play with friends. That is, if I have leather friends in general, because I don't have much friends to play Monster Hunter games with usually. But I'm usually like a solo, going solo, get my butt whooped, only killing like four monsters of the same kind. that's me with typical Monster Hunter in a nutshell. Anyways, let's take off the shrink wrap by using the good old Nintendo ribbon. Oh, so satisfying. Not ASMR kind of satisfying. Anyways, let's move that over there. Open her up and see what content we're inside. Ah! We got ourselves this bonus DLC thing. Because as you can see, you just rub off the code on there. That's a bit different from the usual. Because it's got all different languages. That's new. Hey, that's new. Not so sure what that QR code is. I don't think it is the code or whatever. I think it's just an advertisement. I don't know. Like, trailer-wise, this is what you get in the DLC or whatnot, unless it's, like, instructions using the QR codes. And we got ourselves this really nice artwork, or whatever monster that is. And here is the game itself, and all that jazz. I'm not so sure if there's not only just the DLC, I don't know how much and many megabytes it is in terms of if there is a day one patch coming out. Who knows? We'll have to see on that. Anyways, let's stop from there and move on to the extra goodies. And that is, we got ourselves a steel book, which is a nice steel book, as you can see here. Here's the side, here's the back, and it's got the good old Nintendo approval kind of thing. And we'll get the stabber knife for this one, and be careful because of a little bit too far on the last and unboxed a steelbook. I know a majority of people like the steelbooks, but I don't know why, but I might as well pre-order this with the steelbook. That comes with a steelbook. Either way, move that to the side a bit. And we open it up and see what content we've inside. And it's basically just a nice and decorative and thing. No pattern at all. kind of stinks, really, to be fair. And here's the back again. So you just used to get like a... Oh, let's see if I can do it like that. Yeah, there we go. That's a bit more better. Anyways, but yeah, that's that in a nutshell. That's the steelbook. And then we got ourselves some key rings in their little baggies, which I might leave in the baggies because they do have some nice artwork. So what is it? Just metal. You can't kill the metal. The metal will live on. Pugwot tried to kill the metal. You know, I don't want to get copyright for singing that. Anyways, but you get what I mean. And yeah, it's just metal and good old metal on it. Metal on metal. Yeah, you can hear that. It's just metal. Anyways, but yeah, that's that. So those are my things that I got from pre-ordering because of it's not like an Amazon exclusive kind of thing because you can get them when you pre-order in certain stores because Game does it. I think Spiff's does it. I think some other places does it. But anyways, I thought I'd buy as a pre-order and get the extra gubbins and it's ordering whatever on Amazon since, you know, we're still in that phase, you know, because I can't go. Wasn't I can't go out. I would go to my local stores, but, you know, they're still shut at the moment and whatnot, if that's another thing. In a nutshell. Anyways, I'm really going into the tangent now. We'll leave with that now. So that's my opening. Anyways, I better go now. See you from Stevie T Films. Happy hunting!